Today we are going to learn Java with BlueJ for ICSE class 9th. This is the third chapter called Values and Data Types. Now let us see what is the scope of this syllabus. We are going to learn character sets, then Unicode and ASCII, what is Unicode and what is ASCII, then what are the escape sequences in Java, what is called a token in Java, what are the different types of tokens, what are identifiers or variables, what are the different types of data types in Java, and how the type conversion is done. So these are the points we are going to learn in this chapter. Now let us see what is the character set that can be used in Java programming. Which are the characters? The character sets. We can use letters, digits, operators and punctuation marks, which is also called delimiters. As we use English language in India, so we can use all the characters of the English language, which comes from the Latin characters. So these are the letters, capital A to capital Z, small a to small z, all the 26 alphabets. Then we can use the digits, 0 till 9, these are the basic digits, we can use all of them. And then there are operators, arithmetic operators, logical operators, relational operators, and punctuation marks. So these are the arithmetic operators. You can find them all on the keyboard. Plus, minus, asterisk, forward slash, and percent. This is the addition operator, this is subtraction operator, this is multiplication operator. We use asterisk as the multiplication operator. We use the forward slash as the division operator. And this is percent, this is the modulo operator. It gives us the remainder of the division of two digits. Then we have logical operators. This is AND. If you type AND two times, it becomes a logical operator and it is still called AND. These are the straight lines. These are standing lines. If you print the standing line two times, it becomes OR operator. This is the exclamation mark. It is used as a NOT operator. AND, OR, and NOT. These are the logical operators. Relational operators. These operators are used to compare two values, whether one value is smaller or greater or equal to another variable. So this is smaller than or equal to, greater than or equal to, equals, equals. If you type equals, equals two times, this becomes a relational operator. This can be used to compare two values to find out whether they are equal or not. If you use the equals to operator for only one time, then it becomes an assignment operator. Then exclamation mark and equal to, this becomes a not equal to operator. Then let us see the punctuation marks or delimiters. We have a dash here, a semicolon, a colon, a question mark, a full stop, and these are round brackets. This is the opening bracket, this is the closing bracket. Then we have curly bracket or curly braces, opening brace, curly, closing brace. These are the square brackets, opening bracket, closing bracket. So we can use these punctuation marks. And all these letters, digits and operators can be found on your keyboard, on your computer's keyboard. So we can use all of them when we are typing a Java program. Now let us learn what is ASCII and what is Unicode. When the computer revolution began in Europe, most of the countries that were using computers had one thing in common. They were using the Latin character set. Most of the countries in Europe, even if their languages are different, such as English or Italian or French or German, but the characters that they use to write their language is the same. It is the Latin character set. ASCII contains the Latin characters. The same character set that we just saw is the ASCII character set. When we type anything from our keyboard into our computer. The keyboard can send the information of the character into the computer. But when we are programming, as you know, all the information in a computer is stored as binary digits, 0 or 1. So every symbol or every character has to have a unique code so that the computer can identify what are we trying to say or what are we trying to type. So every character has a binary code. So this coding is called ASCII character set, American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Here you can see an image of the ASCII character set. So for some time period, the ASCII character set was enough for English and other Latin based European languages. But when other countries started to use computers, there was a need to accommodate other languages also, such as we use several languages in India which use different scripts. We use a Devanagari script. The Devanagari script is used in Sanskrit, Hindi, Marathi, Sindhi and Nepali languages. Apart from that, there are other character sets, such as there is Tamil or Urdu. These all have their own character sets. So to accommodate these and other character sets from other countries, the Unicode was created. Unicode has blocks for all the languages of the world, all the major languages of the world. So that is what Unicode is. Here you can see the Unicode block for Devanagari language that is used in Hindi and Marathi programming. So I think that is enough introduction for ASCII and Unicode. I will stop here, and in the next video we will learn about tokens in Java.